A happy hello to each and every person watching this video. I, Supriya Vijayarangan, working as a teacher of English language in Hosur Public School, have come here to share with you all my challenges and experiences during this sudden change in the teaching and learning methodologies thanks to COVID-19. First and foremost, I would like to thank our respected Principal Bindu Ma'am and our school management team for trusting in us. I would also like to thank Atma Foundation for taking this initiative in giving us this wonderful opportunity to come forward and appreciate each one of us. The first and foremost thing that I had to do was to believe in myself that I can do it. We have been using digital devices and technology for doing some sort of data collection presentation. We never thought these resources would become the only way to reach out to our students, our children. We use software as a resource for recording the results of our activities, our content, but now software has moved into this methodology one step ahead to the next level. We cannot think anything else but some app, some system that would make the learning process easy and interesting. We then had a very huge responsibility to make our parents believe us that we can do it. We can transport this learning to our students through the way we are, though we are far away or at a distance. We then focused on training our parents and students to adopt this technology and help children to concentrate in this process of learning. I must say, the parents have been highly supportive and their contribution in helping us reach our students through an online platform, through small devices, is incredible. My first class when I attended was learning Google Meet. It was full of excitement and nervousness. Before beginning the class, for our students, we went through a training by our computer teachers. Then we had to practice these processes, these steps, with the help of our friends for 2-3 days. After learning the steps of logging in and switching on the camera and checking whether I'm audible or not, that was an unforgettable moment for me and for my students. The challenge was then to hold on the attention, the concentration of our students. How to make a child listen to me? Then we started preparing PPTs and slowly we moved on to audios and videos. We explored a lot. We ourselves made videos and audios and also podcasts. Our principal ma'am has always been motivating and guiding us to learn new things and implementing those in our classrooms. To create that X factor in our class, we were trained for many different apps like Padlet, Zodo, Kahoot, Jamboard, Whiteboard, Podcast and many more. And still the learning process goes on. All these resources were so useful that we never felt that our students are losing any interest. Once everything was set for us and the students, then we became used to this methodology. Then it was time for us to take the next step. According to the learning process, reflection. Some method had to be adopted for assessing the learning outcomes. We explored further for Google Meet and Google Forms for assessing the children how to create, how to share and get the feedback. This was also another valuable learning that I will never forget. The first time when I tried, I too had some errors. Then we started practicing with our friends again and again, and now I am able to create a Google form or a quiz and use it in my class. My students also have learned how to answer these tests. The next step was Google Classrooms and assignments. Again, we went on through a training and we crossed this hurdle also. Frequently, or you can say, we met parents and we conveyed all our developments and queries to them so that they can be our continuous support and help. These interactions helped us to improve and for the betterment of the learning process. At the end, I would like to suggest that only one thing will help you, that is practice, hard work and perseverance. We will be continuously striving to achieve better and better results further. The reason why we have come so long is because of the collaborative efforts of our most learned principal ma'am, the belief of our parents and the love of our children who have accepted us so well. Thank you.